Topic. So I just wanted to ask you, what's your verdict on it?
I received a phone call from a parent yesterday. The man was demanding from me, to know the legality behind teacher giving questions to students through WhatsApp.
I want to know why you always believe that we are using internet or social media for bad things. Because most times, we're actually just on Wikipedia, we're talking to our friends about an assignment that's happening and a case that's going to happen. I don't understand why every time we mention social media, the internet is just negative in your mind.
I wanted to know if there's any law in Nigeria that actually censors the information on the internet.
How do we encourage e-learning? Even if it's only students for all using social media.
I'm going to start with a question on the issue of law regulating data privacy in Nigeria. Apparently, the ground law, which is the Constitution, Section 37 of the Constitution makes provision for rights to privacy. And you know that if you have any actions or maybe your rights are breached, you can come under the Constitution to seek a redress as regards that. No one is saying that you should not use social media. You should use social media, but we are just talking about the bad aspect of it. Okay, for instance now, someone, just like the example I made earlier, someone having a bit in secondary school, and you capture the person, and the only thing you do is just to for you to upload the picture. Another thing is an example of wasting so much time. Some people cannot live their life without social media. When you are using the social media, you are watching video, you are not learning. Most of us are not learning. I'm an example of it. If I say that, okay, I want to use my phone to check some information, I will end up one way or the other, my attention will be diverted to go and check Facebook, to go and check Instagram, to know what's happening on it. So the only advice I have is that you should use your social media, but you should not waste time. You should not be dedicated to it, that this is where my life is going to be, or like I'm just going to be assessing my phone, I'm going to be doing this, I'm going to be doing that. You should be dedicated to the course of your study.
So when it comes to social media, you know how to use these devices more than your parents. You are not thinking of staying with this. You are an adventurer in this environment. And you adventure so much that you know more than even me I'm talking. Because there is a lot of things I will not be able to do. I will call my children. I'll do this, I'll do that. The only thing is because of my experience, my exposure, I can use it to get something wrong which they cannot do. So, what I'm saying in effect is that you must limit your time on social media. You must be able to discipline yourself. You cannot run away from social media. We learn a lot of things. I do a lot of research from social media. E-learning has been on for a very long time. It's only been more pronounced these days. So you cannot do away with e-learning. In fact, I tell trainers, my colleague, that if you cannot do e-learning, forget it, you are getting out of that business. Because nobody will come and tell you, come and train in my organization anymore. You must be able to start thinking about webinar. You must be able to do webcasts. You won't be able to do a lot of things because the world is changing. Tomorrow we are having another public lecture, and that team is regulating data privacy in Nigeria. When you say you have a law that must be structured on ground, you must be able to report if there is a breach, but that there's not something like that in this nation. We have data privacy embedded in our constitution at NCC, NIDA, but it is not being used. So, nobody can go to anywhere and say, you are using my privacy material the way I don't like it. You cannot do it. You can't say it because there is no law in this nation right now.
Data privacy initiative is a way of enlightening our students on what data privacy is all about. Particularly the use of social media, it has advantages and disadvantages. Yes, they can do e-learning, Google for more information about their studies, about their subjects on the internet. But you see mostly that students, they are more on the Instagram, WhatsApp, on all other negative things. So, and you know, there is no law in Nigeria that really protects us from data privacy. So the essential thing is to let the student know that the social media should be used for positive things, and then they should not use them for negative things.
I really feel very good about going to this seminar because it has really impacted me. It's taught me a lot of proper use of technology. Why we should use it, why we shouldn't use it, how, when, and where to use it. This seminar has particularly taught me to censor the information I put out there about myself, because in the future it can be used for or against me. And it will definitely help me with my academics, because one thing I've learned today is discipline. I've learned today that what I put out there influences my life, not my life alone, my destiny. Not my destiny alone, and that of my family as a whole. Not even my family as a whole, that of the whole world. Because when I put something out that leads to any harm or danger to me, it puts a lot of other people into trouble. Because it has a cascading effect. I'm not the only one that will be affected.
I use social media to promote my works. I use social media to learn from it. But the most challenge we have is the youth of the northern states, more especially where I came from, the northern part of Nigeria.
Let's move on.